Got it. Okay, so IP and I were just talking through the plan for the rollout, alpha, beta, and how we do the testing. So, assuming we get to feature complete, I was thinking that the original test I had for a 3 month revenue cohort that would go three whole releases and no one could get out of it, as a user, that would be really frustrating if I knew my colleague had a different experience or I couldn't get it back. So, we were thinking of ways we could do smaller tests iteratively and change the code immediately based on the feedback. So, IP, you had that first suggestion for,
Yes.
yeah.
So my first suggestion would be that we turn it on for all of GitLab, meaning GitLab employees, because that's a big cohort of over 1,000 people that use it daily, right? It's even 2,000 people. And we probably get a lot of valuable feedback right away because we're all heavy users of GitLab and different parts of GitLab. Different personas and so on. And we can see how many of our employees turn it off if we have like a toggle and they can provide feedback. And we have basically with this also tested the whole mechanism of turning it off and getting feedback and so on before we roll it out to non-GitLab users.
Yeah, we were thinking maybe even a very lightweight modal with one question, like what could we have done better that would have been optional too on that. So if an employee toggles it off, they just answer that or dismiss it, and then they can give us that feedback. And we'll
Yes.
iterate on that. So the feedback we get will take the time to build it out and fix those problems.
Yes. And once we're satisfied with the results, or maybe, because we're amazing, pass it with flying colors right away, I think we should default to, we could roll it out to external users. The question is like, how would we do that? My idea was that maybe in a blog post or whatever, people can opt into it, because if we just choose a random a chunk of 1,000 users, they might not even be active, right? Or if the experience is bad, which we don't hope, but if the experience is bad, it's bad if it's like a high profile user, right? Or if they can turn it off and these kind of things. So maybe we can even get a big cohort that want to opt into this test. And if you have people opting into a test that it's turned on by default, you might even be can maybe even be a little bit more gracious in how much they need to answer if they turn it off, right? And why they want to leave the test or something. That's just something that I thought
Yeah,
of.
so we could
Yeah.
recruit with the blog and UXR could collab with us on that, get the 1,000 users,
Yeah.
and then follow their usage. Did they turn it off? That's a data point, but they're opted in and more invested. And maybe do specific long range testing with them. I'm not sure how that could work from the UXR side, but I like that idea of having them decide to join the test versus us just sectioning off a third.
Yeah.
And then the next question was like, given that this is probably going to be around like January, February, we're getting close to the .0 release. So would there be a way that we could maybe just default that toggle to on if we do really well, if we get good pass with flying colors or manage through these first two quick tests? Is there a world where we could feel confident enough to just default that to on at the .0 release?
I hope so. I honestly hope so that we would default to the thing being on in 16.0 and maybe even remove the toggle, right? So that people cannot opt out anymore. I hope that we can achieve it by that. And maybe we just leave the other code path in so that in case we get really bad feedback from a self-managed or larger customers that we basically could roll back and get the toggle back in and would need to maintain the old interface for a longer period.
Yeah, like if we
But
get bad feedback or if we're really sketchy on where we
yeah.
are, we might have to leave that toggle on for like a year till the next
Yes.
auto where we pull it out. So I think
But
we really have to do an evaluation after our first rounds of testing to know how we feel, how our customers are experiencing it.
yeah, exactly. And then, if everything is good and we don't hear feedback for like one, two releases because people don't upgrade immediately, especially to a major version, You know, we could remove the old code in 16.3 or something like that.
That would be the, I mean, that would be the ideal if that happened.
Yes.
But we would change based on that.
Yes, exactly.
Yes. And then the big test on like upgrades, locking people into that for such a long period of time where we can't iterate feels hard. And not like, I know I was have that in our direction. It was something we wanted to test, but I think we could do a cohort study on usage correlated to upgrade patterns versus if someone has opted in, if they do have the toggle on, then we just look at their behavior versus giving like an actual A/B test on that. That's just sort of where I'm at from this conversation. Cause thinking it through as a user, I don't think I'd want to be locked in with no features upgrading and nothing changing for 3 whole months. That just feels with something so core like navigation, it could just ruin your experience. And then we get a lot of bad feedback.
Yeah.
So that's my takeaway from this is this heavy 3 month. Let's remove that. And let's try to every single one, think of a short 30 day cycle on the test and any long range tests. It'd just be like a long range data study, not necessarily locking down users.
I mean, given maybe we are even able to iterate faster in the first one, you know, turning it on for all of GitLab and maybe just turning on it on for like a day, a week, you know, before we move to like a month. Because I think even just enabling it for a week will probably show us the biggest warts we get need to get rid of.
So nice. Yeah. Okay. Thank you for talking through that with me. I'll send this one over and for our next sync.
Thanks.